Right, so today I thought for our next painting that we'd go out into the real world and do some sketching and maybe use those sketches to do a painting. So I've got together everything I would normally take with me. I've got a pad of Bockingford paper, or sometimes I just cut bits off the paper I've got. I like it so that it's loose, so that I can do more than one and they just dry. I've got a little Winsor & Newton box of paints that I use, and I've had these long enough that I just fill up the little holes with the colours I want, so it's not necessarily the colours that I started with. So I use those, and I've got a brush and a pencil, which could have been a little bit longer, but it doesn't really matter. I've got a teeny tiny pencil, there we go. So that's what I'm just going to take with me, and I'm going to take a bottle of water, and I've got two children with me who also have all of their sketching stuff as well, so it's something you could do with whoever you can drag out of the house with you. Right, so let's go. Okay, so I found this lovely little stream and the kids are quite happy just playing around on the bridge. So I thought I'd try a quick sketch from here because I quite like the fact you've got the stream and the little footpath going into the distance together, and then you've got this lovely clump of trees on the right hand side, and then I want to get some of the willow and the trees coming over the top of the water, as well as the yellow rapeseed. Right, so I'm going to start painting, and I'm going to paint from the background to the foreground, starting with my sky. I've got a little glass pot of water. You want something that's quite heavy so it doesn't get blown away with the wind. And I've got my palette of colours. So I'm going to get the sky wet first. Right down. I'm back at home and I've just transferred my sketch onto a piece of watercolour paper. So I've got my horizon along the bottom third. I've got this big signature tree from my sketch coming in about a third of the way along, and then I've got my stream and my footpath and my fence all leading into the centre of the picture, and then I'm going to start painting. So I'm going to get the sky wet to start with, and I'm putting the water on it in the direction that I want my clouds to go. Down to my horizon. The first colour that's going on is Naples yellow, and that's going to provide the yellowy colour in my sky. I'm wanting that to come in
from the top corner down to my tree. The Ceridian blue. So once the sky is on, I've got a puddle of water at the bottom of where my sky meets my dry land, and I'm going to use that puddle of water to start painting the next layers of land. So I've put in the base layer for all of the landscape, bringing it down from the background into the foreground. And then the only thing I've got left to do is put in the first wash for the water. So what I'm going to do here is take some sky colours and swish them in very horizontally, all the way up. So bits of blue, bits of grey, right across. And then into that, I'm going to pull down my reflection colours into the water, which are my dark greens. And then I'm going to let that dry. Okay, so I've got my base layer on, and now the next thing to do is to start putting my second layer on. So I'm going to start with my trees over on this side, and some of my background trees that run behind the centre of the painting. So I'm going to use a rigger, which is a long skinny brush, for pulling the trees up. And then into that, I'm going to splatter some marks for texture. So I've put my background trees in, and I'm going to use a bit of cardboard now to scratch in my fence line, and I might use some of that to also put in some scrumbly foreground where my bushes and shrubs are. So I've got a straight edge of some scrap piece of paper, and it's the straight edge I'm looking for, so I'll just tear that up. It's the right sort of length, and then I'm going to get a puddle of paint that I can use to dip into. So I've got my Payne's Grey and my Burnt Sienna. Dip into those, and then we'll scratch then with this I can bend it to get it to be the shape that I want. Right, so I've got my hedgerow coming into the picture here. I'm still left with a big space here, which is where my main tree is going to go. And once my background is dry, I can start to think about putting that in, and then I'll work on the foreground afterwards. So I think I'll start with some Payne's grey and brown to put the trunk that's sitting behind here. I'm going to spray around the top of the tree so that when I pull my brush through the droplets, I get a softer look. Now I'm going to put the shadow for this tree in. So just with water, I'm going to stripe across the surface of the stream, and then with my brownie black, I'm following the line. that's that layer finished, so that's the second layer. And then I need to leave it to dry before I can do the finishing touches.
So I'm afraid that I missed filming the very last touches that I've done to this painting. But if you're doing this at home, all I've done is I've added some darks in round the dandelions so that they stand out a little bit more, and a little bit more splattering and speckling up in the trees. Really, you have to work out when to finish yourself, because it's always difficult to know when a painting's finished. So maybe put it away till tomorrow and get it out and have another look. And I hope you enjoyed this workshop, and we'll see what I do next. Okay, thank you.